Number four on my list of the worst of the worst comedians. I don't like Tom Segura. He's number four. I had recently seen an interesting little news piece on a European company, and I don't know if you could call them a music studio. They use some sort of computer programs to analyze, artificial intelligence. It analyzes all of the top 100 hit songs in Europe, and then it finds out all of these hottest riffs and beats and rhythms will spit out what will be a hit song if it's released quickly. Tom Segura is the algorithm comedian of the decade. I have this theory. There is a talent agency and they create media products, and they do this for comedy. They contrive out comedy by some kind of algorithm goes through whatever is like the best joke. No, I think what it is too is they buy jokes. They buy. Okay, so what's Tom Segura? It's Louis C.K.'s discarded jokes that he didn't use, and he sold them to this little production company who created Tom Segura. To get on this worst list, you could be a generic com. I don't know, that's probably not going to catch on. A generic comic. I'm putting it in there. Because Tom Segura would easily fit that. You just go ahead, go through his specials. Even the fucking names of his specials annoy me. And now, these fucking podcasts, he's finding a way to show up 12 hours a day worth of podcasts. He is far too popular. And he is becoming far too wealthy. He's getting far too important for his own good. So he's definitely on this. Boy, there's a guy too that would never think to say, hey man, I'm just like a working comedian. Don't overrate me. Because I do believe that he is, well, he's a robot anyway. He's a product of this fabrication company. Okay, why else is he on this list? Well, guess what? This guy is a jizz comic. He is nothing but jizz comedy. Louis C.K.'s masturbation jokes that he weren't quite good enough, so he sold them to this media production company that wrote them up for their Tom Segura product. Do you ever just see someone's face? Like, when I see this picture, my fists ball up in, like, I can't control, like, I don't even know, I'm not even aware of it, and my fists are balled up. This is the perfect summary. I wonder if they ran a computer program on all of the, the programmed manufactured product jokes that they have made for Tom Segura over the last 10 years, and then they spit out, like, how can we make a generic Tom Segura? And it would be this fucking picture, and it would be this line. So he's doing the I'm Coming Everywhere tour. Look at that fucking face. And that's his whole thing. Did I do that jizz comedy? That sounds like jizz comedy. Who did that? Just zoom in on that. Zoom in on that and feel. It just makes you angry, right? Highly overrated jizz comic. Got this Urkel thing. Did I do that? Oh, he's all lies. Now, this could be tricky because sometimes we understand that the stand-up comedian is playing a character. If you're a fan of stand-up comedy, I've gotten into this. There's people that will cite something said in a stand-up comedy act. Like, they really believe it's a court testimony.
No, dude, he said that was in Fort Worth, Texas when that happened.
It could be a true story. It could then be a true story in which they've changed the names and places. It's a story that happened actually to their friend, but they've changed the story to which it was happening to. and so on. And it could be fabricated entirely. Tom Segura, whose production, his manufacturer, has, you know, told them how to say things in interviews, like, I think being real is the funniest thing, and, you know, I just try to be myself. Honesty is so important in comedy. You just gotta be honest with the audience. But he's all lies. Tom Segura is all lies. Did he overdose on GHB when he was 18 and go into a coma? Who knows? Because he's a liar. Everything's a lie. Everything you're hearing from him is lying. And that includes his act, all the stories on his comedy podcast, everything you've heard in interviews. So none of these stories happened at all. Not in any way. Yeah, that's about the level of his comedy. Humiliating his mother. Oh, he's also at a place where he's, you know, done with his boss, his wife, or his fucking clone product, Bert Kreischer. Now he's at a thing where he is now a corporate product. Well, what'll happen is, he's going to start apologizing and getting woke, and then he's going to start having, they're trying to turn him into like a proper interviewer, celebrity talk show circuit. You know, so you're going to see him become very corporate, very woke, you know, trying to make some kind of appeal for apologies for all of his Louis C.K. jokes that he bought. I think he's on this list because he continues to rise, a mainstream fixture, you know, but he's very average product. You know, you would think he would get on here for drug abuse, but that's all lies. He's not a drinker. He doesn't do edibles. It's all lies. Everything's a lie. So that's why Tom Segura is number 4 on the list of the worst of the worst. You know, I can't even really get angry about him. Because again, how do you get angry at a box of Cheerios? You can't, you know, how do you get angry at the contrived, computer-created European pop songs? You know, it's like you can't. Because it's just like a generic marketing product that just exists, and it's just going to be there. Anyway, I really do believe somebody should stop him. Tom Segura, you're number 4. And guess what? Number 3 is going to be your fucking clone product. What's Tom Segura? Tom Segura's the box of Cheerios. And the other one is Honey Nut Cheerios. The other product comic. Tom Segura, why don't you fuck off?